Well, they were a glamorous couple, and they maintained sort of standards of the time. Presidents in those days did wear ties all the time, all the way through Ronald Reagan, who never went into the Oval Office without a coat and tie on. And the Kennedys were like that. Their glamour, I think, partly came because they had this sort of European style about them that people looked up to in those days. They were sort of a French overlay, if you would. And those pictures are so poignant. Let's go back to the plane. Well, let's look at the horse. The horse pictures here, that horse, I believe that's the same horse. Isn't it there? Yeah, they're putting a bridle on. That's Paul Fay, who was a pal of the president's. They were in the Navy together. They both are on PT boats that were cut
And
down
here's
separately.
Caroline.
Here's
Caroline getting
Caroline
on the
getting up on
horse,
that.
getting on the pony. And this is what we read. I read this today, David Gergen, because if for all the Neil Diamond fans, this is actually where that song Sweet Caroline came from. Apparently, Neil Diamond saw the pictures here, these pictures of Caroline Kennedy riding the pony, and that's what inspired him for Sweet Caroline.
Well, there was such a look of joy in her face in these photos, and that pony, actually, Macaroni was that
pony
pony's
Macaroni.
Name. Exactly, and they used to keep it on the White House grounds. Had roamed the South Lawn, and it was a gift from Lyndon Johnson, the vice president. And if you see those the saddle being put up there right now, it's a very elaborate saddle arrangement, isn't it? It's from the King of Morocco.
Wow.
And it was the Kennedys had made a state visit there. The King gave him that. King Hassan gave him that. And here's Caroline riding that pony, and she just had such joy. And there's John, who, was remembered so fondly in so many pictures from the White House itself. It's wonderful to see these photos released,
but
and
then
these clips.
To sort of juxtapose this joy with the tragedy that would befall, John Kennedy Jr., when you look at him in Marine One, it's a little eerie, is it not?
It is eerie, Brooke, because it was just 36 years later that he went down himself. But it brings to mind how much tragedy in the air did befall the whole Kennedy family. If you think of Jack Kennedy, his oldest brother went down in the war when his plane exploded on a bombing mission. And he was the one who was supposed to be the president. That's what the father had always thought, that Joe would be the president. Along comes Jack Kennedy. He also loses, Jack Kennedy loses his sister in a plane crash in the 1940s when she went down with her husband. A very big romantic couple went down. And later on, Teddy went down in the plane and was badly hurt, but the pilot was killed, as was another passenger. And then of course, many years later, along comes his son. Mm-hmm. So if you think about John Kennedy's life, Jack Kennedy, President Kennedy's life, he had at least four members of his family who were killed in the air.